The ancient door is still locked tight. The control panel beside it flickers with a sizzling sound. I thought we'd find our way back here, Tiber murmurs, but Genji's is watching. Be careful. You're not gonna do anything. They're all gonna attack us if we do. So let's try the other door before we go take the little tour. There it is.
Go.
Oh, there's actually two more. Oh no, this is where he came from, the little Nihilash. So we want to head over here. Yeah, we run over here.
On it.
This door is made of some unfamiliar shiny metal. It has been polished to a mirror-like sheen. A magnetic strip of another, duller material has a strange runic script scrawled across its surface. It looks like an instruction regarding the door. On trying the door, you discover what that message must be. This door is stuck or something equivalent. You might be able to force the door open, but it won't be easy. I'm going to use might to do it. And these people might attack. That we could go anywhere, right? Except for the navigational cortex. 106 episodes, guys. Can you believe it?
Ready.
The shiny door remains stubbornly closed. Force the door open. 50%. Nobody can get... Nobody can get higher than 50%. Nope. You heave at the door, trying to push it sideways, upward, downward, all to no avail. Alright. You forced my hand now. For some reason you can't use that like that. Don't mind us, we're not doing anything. Just be along your way now. It says it uses might. Smashing? Because I don't see might here.
That's the stuff.
I mean, maybe that'll help. ~65%. Success. Ooh, we got critical success. Stat pools restored. Excellent. Some mechanism within the door seems to be stuck, but you manage to overcome its resistance. You hear something crack, and then the door slides open, grinding a bit as it does. You guys don't mind, I hope. Woo, 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 woo. This heavy door is sealed shut. It's the only thing that stands between you and the void. Oh, it's an airlock.
Yes.
What do we have here? Oh, nice! 30 shins, an amplified encephalic rush, a hyper-lutrigated force, which is 6 points of might, 6 points of intellect, 2 concentrated spray fleshes, a cipher called The Cure, Robert Smith, and a an oddity called Smart Traveler's Star. That's worth it, guys. Especially because I got critical and all my stuff was restored anyway. Not Eretus's, unfortunately. This gray metal choker bears a small 9-pointed star in its front and fits snugly when worn, adjusting to the size of its owner. It protects its bearer from small inconveniences encountered during travels and everyday life, including mild to moderate rain, floating road dust, and campfire smoke, allowing her to remain fresh even after days of extensive walking. The choker doesn't stop real danger, though. and the wearer shouldn't walk into a hailstorm or a house fire without some more suitable protections. Our machinery lore tells us that the delicate craftsmanship of the star suggests that the item was not created for simple wayfarers. More likely, it was intended for high-ranking individuals wary of spoiling their expensive attire during the demands of social events. Nevertheless, its usefulness makes it a nice trinket for the Ninth World's adventurers and travelers. That's a cipher. Let me just take all this stuff.
I'm carrying too many ciphers.
I know. We have too many ciphers. Oh, Tiber has a slot open. Let's give him the Dulk. There you go. No, only one over. Minus two speed pull. And she has minus two intellect pull? Ugh. She needs intellect. Yeah, that's fine. Minus 5% on tasks. Okay, so this other stuff we have. Yeah, that's fine. Okay. This thing we got. Yeah, we can't do anything with it, so... it'll be a thing to either hold on to or sell. The cure. Target enemy drops some of their possessions and wanders aimlessly, never attacking, while the cure is active, which is for 6 rounds. This smooth yet multifaceted ceramic sphere refracts and reflects light brilliantly. When hurled, it releases a sparkling gaseous cloud, eliciting feelings of euphoria, empathy, and goodwill from those who are engulfed in its vapors. Wishing to atone for past misdeeds, they fling their possessions outward in acknowledgement of being cured of greed, hatred, and delusion. While in that altered state, they wander aimlessly, contemplating how they may best benefit all the inhabitants of the Ninth World. That's awesome. This appears to be a conduit for a third party's contemplation, as the words come even from creatures that do not know the human language. Our mystical lore tells us that the cure was brought into the Ninth World when a scholar discovered a supply stored underneath an ancient ruin. Some Aeon priests believe that he planned to deliver a large quantity to the Steadfast, but was murdered before he could do so. This sphere may be the last of its kind. That's pretty cool. I love these descriptions. Alright, so we don't want to go into the void. Thinking that we'll take care of some of these other quests. Captain Janner told me that the owner of the helmet was named Achille, but she wasn't particularly interested in Achille's discovery. She did agree to let me keep the helmet. If I want to know what Achille discovered, I'll have to access the navigational cortex myself. Cool. So get knowledge. That's going to be our blue tide, I'm sure. Unfortunately, it's forbidden for outsiders to access the navigational cortex. I've learned that when the cortex is being removed for maintenance, someone in the pit area of the Anchorage needs to press buttons in response to a panel lighting up. If this isn't done, the cortex can't be removed. One of the Lascars, a man named Pilot Major Genjis, is working near the door to the chamber where the cortex lies. If I want to sneak inside, I'll have to distract him somehow. Sounds interesting.
I'm ready.
Let's take care of some of these other quests, though. It was saying I might want to negotiate some more with Draquagen. I beg your pardon.
Gladly.
Well, I know where this goes. I can tell him. Or them. Garkoto. Tell me, what is the state of the new maw here in my settlement? I opened the new maw, but I found some kind of terminal or port on the other side. Not your city of Nyliash. Garkoto hisses in disappointment, and its great bulk thrashes in the tank. Alas, it would appear that we must remain in the bloom for now. We shall find another route home eventually. The murky gases swirl around the prince's corpulent form. Opening the maw has served the residents of Little Nyliash. Name your fee. I have so much money. I do not ask a fee. I sought to find a way to Nyliash for your people, and I failed.
I'll remember that.
Indigo Tide. Now, if he'd chosen the other one, that saying I wish to only help people, that would have been gold, I'm sure. You do us all an unexpected honor. You have my gratitude, Kestoff. Alright, so we got Indigo Tide a moderate amount, and 25 XP. Farewell, Garkoto. May you achieve your goals this day. Running out of quests. Yay!
All right.
Tony, I'm loving this game. I'm gonna... Unlike some other games I'm playing, I'm gonna be really, really disappointed when it's over, but at the same time, I have so many other awesome games I'm looking forward to getting to.
Yes.
See, she even knows. And she's just in this game. Okay. Arechi. I have great news, Arechi. Arechi, whatever. Sought have we, but alternate routes to the Anchorage remain closed. Your fortune. Has it been better? Let me see if there's any more questions we can ask first. Her jaw unclenches by the smallest fraction. Naturally, this one will seek to provide informative truth. Yeah. It looks like it... Let me start over. There's no other questions we need to ask. Oh, is there? Okay. Just the wording is weird. I found a maw in Little Nyliash. It looks like it leads to your anchorage. No, it leads to your anchorage. We get another cipher. Sickness. For the first time, a broad smile cracks her face. A savior. Truly, the opener of the ways who can rescue maroon travelers. She turns and speaks to her crewmates. Challen, Esken, Tuveld, Getsa! She turns back to you and presses a small device into your hand. It is useful. Old, but reliable. She thinks, ah, this woman is a skilled navigator in this realm of flesh. At last we will return home. To the anchorage, that is. Gold Tide raised a small amount. Yeah, greasing fiddle. Changing tool. Whoa. 150% on quick fingers tasks and smashing tasks. Lasts for 3 uses. A silver needle as long as a finger sticks out from this black metallic ring. The band is about as wide as a fingernail and has 2 golden metal plates on it. Touching one of the plates causes the needle to soften, letting it be shaped into a helpful tool for most situations. That's awesome. I like that.
I'll remember that.
Farewell, helper. Farewell. Now if we screw up, we're gonna have to fight them too, I bet. Yeah, quest updated, quest complete. Yeah, might be willing to offer he might be willing to offer something valuable in return. I'll walk to that fear. Is there anything new to say? Kind of a strange feeling. Yeah. Briska said she saw a ghost dressed in rags with a long beard. Are you the old Memavera? He's lucky to remember. His eye sockets focus on you, and his expression gains a semblance of life. The Memavera. Briska. He looks at his ghostly hands, and when he looks back up at you, a light seems to blaze in the holes of his face. Was I the old Memavera? Oh, yes. Oh. Yes. I ruled the bloom with strength and wisdom, and the slums ran red at my word. The Council of Sagus Cliffs feared me. The merchants who trod my streets paid me. My word was law, and none dared stand against me. He thinks that is who I am. No, not who I am. Who I was for a time. His lips part in a feral smile as he grasps at the memories, at the last memories in his mind. The new Memavera. Pah! What has she done worth mentioning? Who trembles at her voice? Tell me, who fears her steps? Who among her people wouldn't slip a blade into her back? Oh, she did for me, it's true. Her and her coterie. But I had loyal retainers to the end. Loyalty and fear, like a fist. She may have taken my place, but she'll never match my rule. Looks like her rule is almost over. If the bloom hadn't turned against me after my decade in power, I'd be there still. But she dragged me to the heart of the beast, and let it sift through my mind, fed it all my crimes, and then she left me there. He swallows. Ask your questions of me, while the fragments of memory still linger. Ask now, and make the questions count. Huh. What happened in the heart of the bloom? She brought me through a new maw, an entry to the heart I'd never seen. It was then that I knew what she intended, and we fought. But she was fast and strong, and I was old and drunk. She didn't kill me, though. Oh, no. She wanted me to suffer for the crime of raising her up. She bound me there, and she stood above me and reveled in my pain as the bloom sucked away everything that I was. I'll say this for her. She was better at malice than I ever was. He thinks, such excruciating pain. But that memory slips as well, thank the gods. Tell me about your reign as the Memavera. He smiles, a cruel thing almost lost in his beard. I live with my knife in my hand. I never lost my love for its kiss. I took what I wanted, and I shared with the rest of my crew. But I had laws, mind you, laws and strictures that kept the merchants pouring through the bloom. No sense in scaring off the easy meat. No need to be greedy. They said I was weak, but that was because they didn't know how strong I truly was. And that's why the bitch came for me. Too grasping, she was. How did the new Memavera unseat you? She knew the bloom was angry with me. She told me she'd been below, and she'd seen something that she thought might explain why I lost my bond. I didn't know she'd hidden her killers around the bloom, or that she was the one who'd ruined shipments or driven off the citizens. She put her muscle into play, and I never even saw it, and she took me to the heart of the bloom. He swallows. What do you think of the new Memavera? The memories slip, lights skittering down a tunnel. As I grab at them, they go. No, his voice pleads. Stop them. They're me. Yeah, that looks like three questions only. I cannot remember. You forgot now. So let's talk to... what's his name?
I'm ready.
Dracogen.
Yes, now.
Is So is he gonna give us something in advance or what? There's some sick people here, baby. Dracogen's voice is less patient. You return again. Surely this time you bear what you promised. He sniffs the air. Alas, you do not. The time of mere mortals is not as of the same scale allowed to cast-offs, friend. I urge you to speed your search. I've heard that you have sought the Cortex from the Anchorage before.
I'll remember that.
He bows slightly. Indeed, as I mentioned, I have an interest in unique artifacts, and I occasionally fund expeditions to find these artifacts. When the bloom opened on the Anchorage, I offered the reward to the team that could bring me interesting treasures from the location. Alas, the Lascars caught and prosecuted my employees. He smiles. When we have concluded our business with the amulet, I may have a proposition for you. I do have a journal. Magmatic amulet from the Ascension. Well, we're gonna get the Cortex first.
Yes, now.
For some reason he doesn't mention that he wants us to do that as well.
I'm going.
Yep, we're going. So we'll see if we can get a, what do you call it? A tour of the place. We'll see what we can do.
Yes, now.
I prefer not to fight them all. It's way too valuable to them. They're not going to just give it to us. And there's nothing that we can trade that would be worth it to them.
All right.
At least I really doubt it, so we have to use subterfuge and trickery. Sneaky wiles to get it. Like, you know when we take it, there's some huge alarm that's gonna go off, right? With alert. But maybe it's something we can just leave instead of killing all the... I don't want to kill all these people. So, distract him. Have him go away. And while he's doing that, smash our way in here, and then someone else needs to be at this panel, I'm guessing.
We shall see.
Unfortunately, I can't position anyone there because we can't move people tactically around. Only when we're in combat, people just follow each other, like, continuously. Gotta save for us before we do this. I'd like that tour you offered. He smiles wildly, spreading his hands. Yes, of course. Follow me. You have already seen the elevator room. You will now see the observation deck where you watch for the coming ship, where we study the path of the stars. Follow, please. Yep, it's a crisis. Keep Genji's occupied with the tour. Access the Cortex room. First, see this. The paths between stars. The journeys that took us to this place. And please, ask questions if you have questions. Yes, we should do that, Tiber says quietly, beneath his hand. The longer we keep him talking, the more time we have to find the Cortex. Tiber, okay, you want to be the sneaky one, don't you? Actually... who has that? It's me that has that. Can I give it to him? No. Well, can someone else talk to him then? Because I have the 150%. Alright, Tiber, you talk to him. Any questions have you before we continue? Do you have names for any of these stars? Some, yes, he shrugs. Others, no. Much has been lost. He gestures you along, urging you to follow him. Okay, Aretis. I would like to go... he can press the thing. You're gonna press a button, baby. Okay, I go back here. Should I do it now or wait till he gets... I'm thinking try it now.
Ready.
I might not be able to do it this time because I ran so far. Looks like I could. Oh no, maybe not. Yep. I can't do anything. Calistige. So, studying this display could help your people find their way home? He blinks rapidly, surprised by your question. Some of us believe this. They come here when they have no work to stare at the changing paths. To draw their own maps and... dream? Yes, dream. He pauses, gathering his thoughts. He stares into the changing stars. His eyes are filled with their light. I believe that the paths between the stars are too many. That we must wait for the ship. He sighs deeply. We must move along now. Am I supposed to keep him talking or move him away from here? I don't know how to move him away. Apologies, I do not have much time. Should keep moving if you want to see everything. Okay, do I move now? I'm not sure what I'm supposed to be doing. Move him? I mean, he wants to move, right? Kind of strange, though. Shouldn't he be leading the way?
Happy to help.
Okay, we have him by the button.
Yes.
Hold up. What does this help with? 150% on smashing tasks.
I'm ready.
If I go lore machinery, I get 80... I can get 100%. Yeah, let's do that. Even though I know I chose myself for the smashing and quick fingers, but I might need it still. Cool, critical success. My stat pools are restored now. You tap the symbols at random, noticing that the light behind them goes out when you hit certain buttons in sequence. Clicks and mechanical snaps sound within the door as you work, glancing back occasionally to be sure you haven't been discovered. With no warning, the door opens. With a sizzling pop, the panel goes utterly dark, and you smell burning wires. You won't be closing this door again, it seems. Where's the pop? Looking for a pop. Can I look at all these things freely? You can't read the text on this display, but the graphics seem to depict atmospheric conditions and power levels in the room. It's just a monitoring station. Nothing can be controlled from here. Waves of coherent thought radiate from the orb, flooding your mind with strange abstract calculations and mathematical formula. It shines so brightly that you can't look at it for long. Okay. I can't also interact. I can run up right here, though. Too far away.